everybody. It's been a little bit since I've been back on YouTube. I've been doing parties, getting orders together, trying to work at nighttime. I've been very busy. So I haven't posted in a little bit. But today I'm going to do my order for Wine Caddy. So I got the sublimation. So we're doing sublimation today. And I got the sublimation Wine Caddy here. And then I have the sleeves to go on the glass. These sleeves are going on these glass. These are the big glass, but I think it'll still be all right. If, as long as it fit, it'll work. So the sleeve going to go on here. When I finish pressing my image into the sleeve, it can go on here, and then they can take it off when it's time for them to, you know, wash their cup, or they can just keep the sleeve on if they just want to use it for decoration. So the picture is going to be on the front and on the back. These sublimation things I ordered from Etsy. There's a coaster for the glass to sit on, and then there's a caddy that goes on top of here. So I picked the picture that I'm going to use. It's a Gucci art wallpaper type of picture. I couldn't figure out what to put, but they told me to pick what I want. So right now I'm going to just size everything up, and then I'm going to use my Cricut design space to put the picture on with it. So the sleeves. So size everything, and then I'm going to put it together. So there are 4.5 by 3.5 for the sleeves. And the coasters are 4 by 4. And the caddy itself is 9 by 4. So now that I got all of these together, I will put my sizes into my Cricut design space, and then I'm gonna go from there. I'll be passed up. I'm gonna use this Gucci image, and this image is, I'm gonna do slicing. So I'm gonna upload the sizes that I need through the shape. And we're going to start with the sleeves. Come on. So the sleeves are 4.5. 4.5 by 3. So we have to unlock it. And then the height will be 3. 3.5. So we're going to shorten it. 3.5. Okay, and then we're gonna lock it. So now I'm gonna make my image smaller so that I can just slice this picture out of there. Just like that. And that's gonna be on the glass itself, this image. So we're gonna slice it down here. So whatever shape you put on there, you can slice it. So that's going to be for each coaster. Get rid of that. And that will be a duplicate. And that's for the coasters. So we're going to close them out. Then we're going to go back and upload that shape again. And this time we're going to do the caddy, which is a 9 by 4. Let's see how much stretching we can do with this. Nine by 4 inches wide. So it's 9 inches wide by 4 inches in height. 9 inches wide by 4 inches in height. So Let me continue it bigger. And this is going to be for the caddy. So I'm going to go ahead and put that over there too. And I'm going to do the coasters. All four by two. Look at my measurements I got. All the coasters are 4x4. Well, I got coasters 4x4. Alright, so it's 4x4 for the circle coasters. I'm going to put the image back in again. I'm going to get a 4x4 circle this time. And you want the circle to be 4. Let me go 4-1 to make sure it covers the whole thing. 4-1. So now make this smaller. I want to get that whole Gucci in the middle of it. I'm going to slice that. All right. Get rid of that. Get rid of the excess. And we need two of these. And I'm using... So I got my two of these. And I'm going to use my sawgrass. Let me get this one cut out. This one, this one. So you got these two. Along with these two. So I'm going to screenshot it and send it to my printer. Because it's easier. I'm going to minimize it. Double tap it. Now let me hook up. Let me put my USB cord ready for this one. My sawgrass don't come with the, it's not wireless. So I have to use the USB cord, which is fine for me because it's a long cord. So I'm going to print this picture out. And I'm going to use my sawgrass 400. One print. I got the heater on already. So the paper's coming out. So I can minimize that and go back to Cricut Design Space. So now this is one for the caddy. I'm going to go ahead and screenshot that one. The way I do things is just easier for me to screenshot instead of trying to do it the other way. All right, so here's my image. I'm going to go to File, and then I'm going to Print. Then I'm going to look for my sawgrass up here. And then print. So now that I got everything together that I'm gonna need for this project, this sublimation project, I got my tape. So, I'm going to be doing all this with one hand. Be patient with me because I'm filming at the same time. There you go. So, if the camera go off, it's because I'm using one hand. So, I have it at 410 and I'm going to press it for 1 minute. Wait 1 minute, then I'm gonna put the next one in. I feel most likely most everything for sublimation is always 1 minute. So these little clips here, these things I bought from Dollar Tree, it's not really hot, but it holds the paper in place. You know, that's what I use them for, just to hold the paper in place on top of my thing, because you don't want to forget not to put the paper on there, and then you get all the sticky stuff up there and mess up your machine. So, you know, things cost too much money. We don't want to mess up stuff. All right, it's almost done. All right, y'all, let's check out these results and see what's popping. Let's bring this one off. Look at that. Isn't that nice? It turned out really nice for the coasters. Let's see about this one. Because this one we have to put the mugs, we have to put them back in again because we have to do the other side. But it turned out really nice. It's hot. Okay. It's pretty. Just for the front of it. I'm going to put it back in. I'm going to press the other side because we've got to put image on both sides of these sleeves. And I like this. To my lady that shared it, and I think it was this group. All right, let's put this one in now. This is the wood sublimation caddy. If anybody got any information about finding the whole slate, the whole thing, where as though I can cut, because I have a glow for it, so I can cut what I need out myself after I sublimate. If anybody got any information about that, let me know. Because I can buy them and cut my own stuff out, opposed to, you know, buying them from the store. So, here they go. They're looking nice. All right, y'all ready to see what happened? Maybe I should let it dry first, because it looks like it's sticking. Let me let that dry first. And anybody, somebody knocking on the door? Let me let this dry, because it looks like it's trying to stick. So maybe the paper needs to be dry first, or maybe did I probably pressed it too much, because I did it one minute. 1 minute might be too much. So, I'm going to let that dry a little bit and come back. So, I know that this is stuck to this paper. And something, I think I pressed it too hard, pressed it too long, or did something to it. But I'm going to try and peel it off and see what happened. Because, yeah, that guy didn't want to come off the paper. Like the whole coating done come off. Some sticky substance is coming off, so. Let me peel that. I guess that's how it's supposed to be. No, I think I pressed it too much because the whole coating looked like it came off and it stuck to the paper. Now, I don't know why it did that. Why did the coating came off, because they could have sold me something cheap. I don't know why that happened. Why did it stick to the paper opposed to, just basically being stuck to the wood like this, like your poster. And if y'all have any suggestions, let me know why. I don't know. Not really a matching set if we got all these different. This one is lighter. Oh, I think I know what I did wrong. I guess you're supposed to peel the surface off first. I'll tell y'all, this is my first time trying this. I'm going to try it again since the heat thing off, and I think that's the surface that's supposed to be peeled off first. So let's try again. Let me print out another sheet. All right, Duncan, be safe. It's all grass. All right. So there's a lot of trials and tribulations when it comes to doing stuff and learning stuff. So I'm going to try. I'm gonna try that again. And this time I think I'm supposed to peel the film off, which I didn't do. You know, when you buy this, it don't come with rules. But there is a film. There you go. So now, this one should not have any problems. Remember when y'all buy these sublimation pieces, they come with tape on it. Okay, now we have the good surface. So this one, I'll just keep on my own stuff. So the picture is ready. And it's mirrored. Let's put it back on there and try again. Because I know something was going on. Like, why is this thing stuck to the point the whole paper is, the plastic is stuck on the dang on paper. But like I said, it's my first time doing this Caddy set. And I see that you now have to make sure you check for paper and plastic. All right. So this time the plastic, when I left the plastic on, this is what it looked like. It's not so bad, but I think it's supposed to match with the rest of it, and it don't. The color's distorted. So now I gotta remember, I always make sure I check for the plastic. So here you go. Let's take it off and see if we have a whole matching set. But when it comes to crafting, you know, there's gonna be mistakes. Look at that, y'all. Isn't that pretty? Pretty, pretty, pretty. Oh, ooh, ooh, ooh. Hot. Hey. Make sure y'all like and subscribe to my channel. Make sure y'all watch my videos. See my mistakes before y'all do your own projects. Okay? So let's put this all together and see how nice this gonna look. This goes on top of the bottle. Look at that. Let's put these, look at the coasters right here. They're gonna be happy with this set. I thought I'm waste messed up by not mirroring my other one. Let's put this back on here. Hopefully it won't look too distorted. I put it on the glass first to stretch it out to make sure it fits. You know, I stretch it out before I subbed on it to make sure it was. It's hard getting these on. My glass could be too big, but these are the ones I had in the house. So when I do decide to go, when I go back to the dollar store, I'm gonna take the sleeve with me to find some proper glass that this will fit, so it won't look so distorted. When I but it still looks nice. You can see that it's the color changes when you put them on, but it's different. It's cute. I mean, it's different. I like it. It's nice. I'm gonna put that on top of that coaster right there. I'm trying to squeeze this one on. I am going to go to Dollar Tree tomorrow. And I'm also going to go to IKEA because I'm off. Because I want to get some more peg boards for my room. This can be a challenge. Good lordy. It's getting on there. Maybe I'll leave it at the bottom. I don't have to go all the way up there. Gotta break my fingers trying to get that joint there. You leave it down to show more of the glass part where you put your mouth at. Okay, I think that's better. So, we got the coasters. We got the wine caddies. What y'all think? Y'all like it? Y'all think it's a nice thing to, and something simple and easier when it comes to, you know, selling these things or whatever. You put it on here, hang it up. There you go. And I have a long wine cooler thing, because I checked on Etsy and see, you know, what people selling. So they normally sell the sleeve for the two cups, the caddy, and the two coasters. Now, if I was to make the caddies on my own, once I find out where to buy the board at, that's already been selling me the board, I would stretch it out and make it a little bit, just a little bit wider, you know, for this big glass. Because you should be able to customize them. So, there's my DIY on Sublimation on caddies. I hope you like it. I like it. I think it's cute. And you can pick any picture you want. Any picture you want. Look at that. I think this would be a nice gesture for Mother's Day. It's coming up. Stuff like Valentine's Day would be nice to have this. And you know what? I might even do the whole set. Find me a box big enough to put the whole set in there, along with the wine. These, you know, the wine cooler thing, the big tall wine cooler thing, you can sub a picture on that. I think it's nice. I like it. I hope y'all like it too. Watch my videos before you try my stuff. I don't edit anything, so if I make a mistake, y'all see it first before y'all do it. Please, people, make sure you don't forget to mirror these things. Just don't forget to mirror it. Other than that, I give it a thumbs up. I like it. I will be making some more. I see that some of the might need a little teeny stitching up there. You don't want nothing falling apart when you give it to people. But I like it for the most part. All right, thanks for watching this video. Going out, y'all. Y'all got that Sublimation. Go on to Etsy and order some of these Sublimation caddy kits. The sleeves, the coasters. Caddy, don't forget to take the plastic off. Look how pretty that turned out just by taking the plastic off compared to this one. All right. Thanks for watching.